Welcome back to the channel. I just thought I'd give you a heads up in case you didn't know, and certainly I didn't know until a couple of days ago, and that's how you need to open and close your MacBook. Now, firstly, I'm not joking. If you go onto Reddit, you'll find a lot of people who have cracked their screens, particularly the M1 model. Okay, so what happens is when you close the screen, depending on where you close it, okay, there should be no pressure on the actual glass. Okay, so the MacBook's got a glass panel. Okay, if I decide to pull it in the corner, I'm putting pressure on that glass panel. And what people have done on Reddit is shut the MacBook from the corner. So I'm actually too scared to demonstrate, to be honest. It should be shut down from here. Okay, and then opened up from here as well. But what people are doing is they're doing it from the corner. They're slamming it down, they're opening up, whipping it up. Now, I have to admit, I've done this on laptops in the past, particularly ones that are fractional at the price. And because they're plasticky and the screens are sort of cheap plastic as well, they can last a bit longer, which does not make sense at all, but that's just the way it is. Whereas this one, it's the glass panel will just crack if you do it. And I think it kind of seems it's more for the laptops that are on the move, particularly students where it's thrown in a bag and they're quickly opening and they're shutting it quickly. I mean, generally human nature is, if you spend a lot of money on something, you're gonna take care of it. And that's what I tend to do. So I'm fine sort of doing this and then opening up. Now, admittedly, my laptop isn't actually on the move a lot. So it benefits me in that respect. But just make sure you have a good case as well. I mean, you want to keep it shut. But then, although this is aluminium, you don't really want any pressure on it, as that could put some sort of force. And then even when you're opening it, okay, it's got to almost be balanced. And you can open it shut. Puts a bit of pressure on the hinges, you can do that, but do not do it from the corner because you're pulling it, you're bending it, and it'll immediately crack it, or you'll have micro cracks in certain places. And particularly for me, if I broke this and there was no Apple Care, I wouldn't be able to afford a new one straight away. I'd have to stick with my iPad Pro, maybe just get another cheap laptop until then. But I've got this case, which I'm going to post on the affiliate link description. I'm going to post in the description as an affiliate link from Amazon. And it's quite sturdy. I had a bit of a research and I had done a review on this one. So please make sure to check that one out. Let us know what you think in the comments below. Subscribe, please, if you haven't, as the channel is slowly growing. And until next time.